Hey guys, Brandon here. This week we're going to look at four basic boxing combinations. I would probably say starting with these, if you're brand new, would be ideal to get these four basic combinations down. And then from there, once you get those down, you can really branch off and it's a lot easier to add on different punches and different combination sequences. So let's jump right into it. First one is actually really not a combination, it's just a single punch and then start a jab. Probably the most basic, maybe most important boxing punch there is. And real quick, if you're right-handed, your left side is always going to be forward. So for most of you right-handed people out there, this is going to be your left straight punch, what we call a number one punch or jab. So for the number one punch, we're going to add some footwork into this. We can, I feel like usually people, when they're throwing punches and combinations, especially if they're just learning, they don't move their feet. Their feet are pretty planted, and then they just start throwing. So we're going to go ahead and, from the beginning, incorporate some footwork into this. So all that means is standing back, a little bit out of range where I can't hit the bag from where I'm standing, and I'm just going to take a simple step in forward as I extend my left arm and throw my jab. So when I'm doing this, I'm out here, I'm a little out of range, I step in, and I land my punch. Big thing with this I like to focus on, making sure you get your arm fully extended. Really important. Better range, you're actually going to have better power. And so oftentimes this is probably the biggest thing I see is people land their punch straight, especially straight punches here. Arms bent, I'm not gonna use much power, I'm jamming myself, I don't have the range that I would, and I'm landing. The second thing I like you to focus on is where you're landing on the punch on your hand. It should be the top knuckle, especially the top of the first two, your index and your middle finger knuckles. And if we're, again, if we're jamming ourselves like this, we tend to land with the pinky finger. That's a lot of times when people break their hand. So, making sure I'm fully extending the arm, feeling that I'm landing at the top of those first two knuckles. All right, adding a second punch, their number two punch. One thing with any time I'm throwing a right arm, I would like you to focus on what I call squash the bug. If you ever step on a bug and squash it, you want to do something similar when we throw a right hand. What that makes sure is happening is that my hips are engaged and that my punch, and this is more of a power punch, my right hand, the backhand, making sure my hip is engaged, be using that power from my hip, not trying to create it from my upper body. So after I step in and throw my jab, I'm just going to initiate with my hip, turn my hip, make sure I'm squashing that bug, and then my right arm comes out. Same thing, make sure I'm getting it fully extended in with the top of those first two knuckles. My left hand then retracts back to my face. So the one, two together here will look something like this. Both hands fully extending, nice straight punches. Adding on my third punch to my number three, which is my left hook. So with this one, after we come in with our one, two, then I'm going to come in from the side, again, making sure that I'm hitting basically 90 degrees. That's one thing I always want to try to do is whenever I'm striking, hit it 90 degrees, make sure all the force is going into the target. So when I'm doing that here is I want to make sure my elbow is behind my hand. Biggest thing I see here is people's elbows are low, and again, you're not going to hit with the top of the first two knuckles. You're going to be torquing your elbow, not as much power in the punch. So after the first one, two, come in here, then make sure the elbow is high, and it is behind my hand when I land my punch. Last punch is going to be the number six punch, which is my right uppercut. Same focus, make sure it's coming from your hip, you're squashing that bug, you're hitting it 90 degrees, for now it's going to be at the bottom of the bag here, making sure I'm hitting with the first two knuckles just like every other punch. So the whole thing together will be one, two, three, and then lastly adding my six. So one more time here, got my one, two, three, and six. So all four of those, start with the one, one, two, one, two, three, one, two, three, six, and it'll give you a great foundation to add on different punches, different combinations, and you'll be off and running, having a fun time boxing. So if you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please leave them below in the comment section. My name is Brandon from Silverback MMA. Thanks for joining us this week.